Let us now study the concept of billet of split lens as a limiting case of Young's double slit experiment. In this setup, if we are given with a slit plane on which light is incident from the rear side and it illuminates the slit, and in front of it at some distance A, a convex lens which is split from the middle section is displaced from the principal axis by a distance of separation 2x. Then in this situation, for the convex lens which is above it, principal axis would be this, and for the lower convex lens or the part of convex lens, we can assume that the principal axis is this, and both of these convex lenses or the parts of convex lenses produce their own individual images of this slit. Here if we consider this separation A as the object distance, we can easily find out the image distance by using lens formula. Here we can write for lens formula. Here we can write u is equals to minus A, and the focal length of the lens, if it is given as plus F, we can use 1 by V minus 1 by U, that will be plus 1 by A is equals to 1 by F. And on simplifying, we'll get the value of V. The numerical value of V we are getting is 1 by F minus 1 by A. So this will be AF by A minus F. At this distance, if this is the distance where the image is produced, which is the distance V, then here we can see images can be obtained by tracing the light rays obtained from the slit and incident on the lens. Like, if we consider light ray which is passing through the optic center, it must pass through as it is. And the one which is incident on the lower lens, it will pass through optic center as it is, like this. Certainly, as images are obtained at this distance, this is the point where image is being produced. So if we consider another light ray, neglecting the concept of spherical aberration by assuming that the aperture of lens is very small, the light will be passing through this point and it is reaching over here. Similarly, the light which is incident on the other part of lens, this is the point where light is reaching, and this is the way how light is incident onto the screen also. And here this is the first image S1 and this is the second image S2, which are obtained in the plane which is located at a distance V from the plane of this lens. Here actually this is the image of this slit which is S1, and there is another image of the slit which is S2. For this region where the light rays are incident on the screen, by assuming the size of lens is up to that large level such that it is maintaining paraxial rays, as well as the light rays which are passing through the edges of lens are crossing the region of the light rays which are passing through the center of these lenses, optic center of the lenses. So this is the region where the light rays from both of these slits are overlapping. So this can be written as a region of interference. And in this region of interference, we can find out the fringes, because this distance we consider as capital D. And here the value of capital D we can consider as A plus B minus the magnitude of this V, where the distance, which is the distance between the image plane and the lens, and a small d, which is the separation between the slits. It can be easily calculated by using normal magnification, as if an image of a slit is obtained at a distance y and y above the optic axis which was initially there. So here we can see this is the distance which is the magnification which is produced in the image of this slit. If object is located at a distance x below this distance z, here we can write z is equals to v by u multiplied by x. So similarly here also, with respect to this optic axis, the slit image is obtained at a distance z below the optic axis, because object is x distance above the optic axis. So here z is v by u. So in this situation, the value of y we can write as x plus z. So in this situation, the value of small d here is 2y, and the value we can write as twice of x plus twice of z, which is v by u times x. So it can be written as twice of V by U magnitude times X, which can be written as 2X multiplied by 1 plus mod of V by U, that is the magnitude of magnification produced by the lens for this situation. And if we are having the values of capital D and a small d, we can directly write the value of fringe width in this region. And fringe width beta we can write as lambda d by small d. On substituting these values, we'll get the fringe width.